Hello everyone, welcome to this video series on studying MBA in Netherlands. Because many of you asked me to make videos on MBA in Netherlands and there's not that much information. So here I have with me Shashank Sekhar. You might have seen him in the cricket vlogs. We are playing cricket together. That's how I came to know about him. So maybe Shashank will give a short introduction about his background and then we'll proceed further with the interview about studying MBA in Netherlands. So off to you, Shashank.
Thanks, Ambir. I am Shashank. I am from India. I am from Varanasi, actually. Before moving to Netherlands, I studied mechanical engineering and then I started working for Adani Power. I worked for like almost 6 years in different backgrounds. I started working as a construction project engineer, then slowly moved ahead into business transformation. And finally, when I completed my 6 years there, I decided to, you know, go for higher education and go for like pursue higher management roles there. And that's how the story started for my MBA. And we can like later on discuss how I did all those things.
Okay, good to know. So moving on to the next question. So in which year did you move to Netherlands? And how did you decide to move to Netherlands? Like, was it because of the circumstance or the program you chose, or it was like, okay, what was your situation?
To answer your first question, I moved to Netherlands in the beginning of year 2018. So that is like 2 years ago. My choice of Netherlands was not really like I chosen. I actually came from a program known as Global Management Program of SPJIMR, very reputed management institute in India. In Mumbai, you all might have been knowing already. So I came into contact with them. I applied for GMP, got a call from them, and then I got interviewed, got selected. And then there was this choice. This GMP, Global Management Program, stands for a management degree in Europe, which you start in India, and then you go ahead in Europe to whichever partner college you choose. That is how it goes. So you come to SPJIMR, you choose your partner college, you get interviewed with them, and once you get selected, you obviously qualify for that European college. In my case, it was in Netherlands. So we have like other choices as well. We have partner colleges in France, in Germany. We also have now started like partnership colleges in US, such as Brandeis. Also, we are in talks with some UK colleges. So there are like a lot of colleges to choose from. So I think that is a very good thing to have in the very beginning. And that is how you come into contact with the partner college in the very beginning of your program. And then for the 6 months, you study there in SPJIMR, and then you move to your European partner college. And that is how your story begins, that your half MBA is done in India as a preparatory course. And then you move to your partner college in Europe. There you go into the detailed study of all those aspects. So that is how it's very cool and different.
Okay. Yeah. So I think because when I heard this from his LinkedIn and also when we were discussing while playing cricket, so I was also fascinated by hearing that you can do a MBA half in India, like some portion in India and some portion here. So that's why I thought like it will be good to share his experience. And yeah, so how long then was the MBA program in total, including India and Netherlands?
For me, I studied 6 months in SPJIMR Mumbai. Okay. And then I came here and joined the current MBA batch, which already passed 3 months. And this whole course is like of 12 months. So I had to continue for 9 months. So 9 months in Europe, 6 months in India. So in total, we complete like in 15 months.
Okay.
You complete everything, your education, your thesis, and then you get a degree.
Okay. Well, can you like give a brief background of your time period here? Like, so initially you had 6 months in SPJIMR in Mumbai, and then 9 months here. So can you please give a like, which institute you did your MBA here, and how the program is structured? Like maybe a brief outline of.
Sure, sure. So the program starts at SPJIMR Mumbai, as told earlier. We study there for 6 months, where we do all the preparatory courses. The initial basics are taught, and these are taught in the very Indian way like we like. The courses are quite regressive, and teacher makes sure that you understand everything before you move out. And after the 6 months, you move to your partner college. In my case, it was Nyenrode Business University at Amsterdam. Very cool university, ranked fourth as a most beautiful campus in the world. Very nice. Once coming here, you get a lot of chance to meet many CEOs, many business heads, many business people. So that is also a very nice opportunity to connect with people. And the 6 months of your study is divided into the 6 modules of your MBA. For example, supply chain, finance, innovations, and other things. So that is how you go 1 month in each module. And with that module, you go for an immersion module to a different country. And there you do a live project with different organizations referring to that module. In my case, I went to like Google Zurich, Google London, United Nations Copenhagen, dealing with the specific modules at that time, which I was studying. So that was also a very enriching experience, which I doubt you will get anywhere else. And moreover, the class, the class mixture was like, we had a students of ranging experience of like 3 years and 30 years. So that is a big thing. We get a mix of 19 nationalities. People are coming from different parts of the world. People had already worked in different organizations in different work cultures. And that is the amalgamation when you sit in and when the information flows, that is something you would really like to have in it. So that is the best thing I would say to have it. To sum up, I would say that it is a life-changing experience you should always have.
Okay.
At least once in life.
Okay. Okay. So I guess like, now we already covered the major advantages that you have when you have such kind of a program. So many people ask, apart from knowing about the program, they also are always concerned, obviously, about the finances. So how cost effective is it? The reason I'm asking this is because I know some of my cousin who did their MBA 2-3 years back in RSM University Rotterdam, and they said like it was approximately 50 lakh Indian rupees mm-hmm. for 1 year for their MBA, 50 to 60 lakh Indian rupees including everything. So in this kind of MBA where you are a few months in India, a few months here, so what was your total education expense mm-hmm. In total?
Okay, I would not say a sum, but let me like elaborate how did I do my expenditure. Okay. So we don't pay everything at once. So when you enter SPJMR, you only have to pay the part which SPJMR takes, and that is very a nominal fees. If I try to remember, in my case, it was like around 6 lakhs Indian rupees for the 6 month duration where you spend there in SPJMR. That also includes your accommodation and fooding. And after that, when you move to your partner college, if you are coming via SPJMR, that is the best advantage because you get almost a scholarship of more than 50 to 60%. So in my case, the fee initially was around 40,000 euro, but I had only to pay like 14,500 euros. So you understand the difference and you can do the math how much it was.
Mm-hmm.
And living conditions in Netherlands is like, you can like, you can have like 1,000 euro per month and that would be sufficient. So that is kind of expenditure overview. So 1,000 euros per month for your current expenditures, 15,000 euros for your MBA tuition fees, and 6 to 7 lakh rupees for your Indian MBA part.
Okay, yeah. So, yeah, maybe we will, if possible, we'll put the conversion rates here on the video or maybe in the description below. So, yeah. So how can one apply for such a program and what are the application mm-hmm. requirements in brief of applying for such a program? Maybe you can walk us through based on your qualifications or what is your situation.
Okay. Yeah. So the beauty of this program is that there is not just only one way to enter it. You have like to enter into global management program, there are multiple ways. You can appear for CAT. You can appear for ZAT, you can also appear for GMAT, and there are also some other tests which we accept. You can go into the website and check the details there. And once you have the cutoff crossed, you directly apply through SPJMR website mentioning the priorities of partner colleges you wish to go, and which you can change always at any point, just before your interview as well. Once you are selected for GMP, the GMP entrance automatically takes care of your admission to your partner college, because at the time of your interview,
mm-hmm.
you are once interviewed with a SPJMR panel, and the second round of your interview happens with the panel of your European Partner Institute. Okay. So in my case, there was a representative from Nairobi Business University sitting in the panel.
Okay.
So in first round, I had an interview with SPJMR people, And in the second round, I had my first choice as Nairoda Business University. The second round, I had an interview with Nairoda people and they selected me. That was my first priority. So everything went ahead and that is how we entered.
Okay. So if you are wondering till now, like how you can contact Shashank, I will leave his description, the contact details in the description below. So you can always contact him and ask for more information. So if you can share like what is the minimum cutoff for the percentile during your time, and maybe if it has changed, you can always check in the SPJIMR website, which will leave in the description below. But what was your experience? Like what was the cutoff?
I would say that the cutoff, the selection cutoff depends on the mix you are, the application mixture you are getting. And in my case, I think the average cutoff via CAT was like around 90 percentile. So if you are scoring around 90 percentile, it is a good to have a chance there.
Okay. And with that, you had bachelor's degree in India and how many years work experience?
Okay. So I studied bachelor's in mechanical engineering. And after that, I started worked for like 6 years in Adani Power in different roles as I stated earlier.
It's six years work experience. Okay.
My idea was to have like at least 5 years of experience and then move to further education.
Okay. Yeah, so I guess that will give you an idea, rough idea, like what kind of profile he had before he got into this kind of a program. What are the job opportunities for, because people are always concerned about three things, like the program itself, the cost, and then the job opportunities. So what are the job opportunities after such a program, and can you work when you study in second year in Netherlands? Like you mentioned that you went to Zurich and other places to get experience. So was it like a visit via your university, or was it like an internship, or what is the thing that you can expect?
Okay. So this is the answer which I can like talk in length.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to state very clearly that the employment market doesn't work exactly like it works in India. You cannot expect a campus recruitment here because that thing does not actually exist in Dutch market or European market per se. When we come here, we always have a career and leadership development track, which we always take as optional apart from our studies. So we try to cater and develop the skills which the marketeers are looking into people. And the second thing is like you always try to go into an internship for which you are doing your thesis, and that is how you enter into the real market. You try to connect with people, you talk to different people, you share your stories and tell them how you can solve their problems as such. And most of the times internships do convert into full-time jobs. Otherwise you can always you have to yourself apply jobs into the market, appear into them and crack it. It's not very difficult, I would say, but yeah, it's different than in India. You would have to do preparation, search for jobs, look for people, get connect, go for coffee chats, like all those things. So these things are very different, but at the same time the jobs you get here are also not like what you get in India. The work culture is tremendously different, and that is something you crave for while you move to Netherlands.
Just to give an idea, like how long is the internship period, or how long is the thesis?
Mm-hmm.
For how many months does it reach?
For MBA, the minimum requirement was for 2 months.
Okay.
I did it for 3 months. So that is quite manageable as part of our course duration.
And at that time, do you also get some additional stipend or salary?
Yes. So I received around 700 euros per month apart from my traveling expenses. So being a student, it's a good amount.
Okay. Yeah. So in total, after getting a scholarship and after getting this, roughly how much did you spend in euros at the end of your MBA degree when you finished, when you graduated? How much did you spend roughly after deducting all the scholarship and everything?
I would say 20,000 euros.
Okay.
It's a rough amount which you will you can pay your rents, you can pay your fees, and you can have your food.
I would say that is a very good deal, because I don't know exactly, you can check in the RSM website of Rotterdam School of Management, but I think 2-3 years back it was around 50,000 euro. Don't quote me for this, but just check it, otherwise I'll put it here. But still, it is a good deal because you get variety of experience.
But that is only possible when you come via GMP of SPJ.
Global Management Program.
Exactly.
Yeah. So yeah, because many of you asked, so I hope it will be helpful for if you are planning to do MBA like this and come from India to here. So moving on to the next, after talking about the job, like what kind of salary range can someone expect roughly or on an average after you have such kind of a degree with maybe in your case it was 5 to 6 years work experience. So with some years of work experience and getting a degree like this, what kind of job salary and what kind of jobs also you can expect depending on your field in Netherlands or in Europe?
Again, as you said, it depends upon like what kind of experience you had earlier and how much experience you had earlier. In my case, I had like 6 years of experience, but I would assume everybody has minimum of 3 years experience because that is an eligibility criteria. So even if you have like at least 3 years of experience wherever, it may be in India as well, and you come to Netherlands and you do your MBA, I would expect to you to get a job of around a gross salary of 50,000 euro per annum.
Okay. So that salary, I mean, it also depends on individual situation, but roughly how much can you expect on hand with that kind of salary per month? Roughly, like a range.
If a range you want to know, then I would say 2,500 euros in hand.
Okay. So after the tax.
And that is actually, I'm talking to a minimum, lower level, okay. not even an average.
So it can go as high as 2,800 or
2,500 to 3,000. I would say
okay.
It's a range.
Okay.
On an average.
Okay. So yeah. So what is one thing that you like about the program and one thing you dislike about the program?
The one thing, actually, there are not just one thing that I like. There are many things. The European Immersions Program. We had chance to like go to 7 countries in 7 months. Incredible. You also have chance to meet CEOs of top Dutch companies like Philips, like DSM, which is like a rare thing to have.
Mm-hmm.
And the SPJMR experience you are having, that is for life. And the thing I dislike the most, if I had to choose one thing, that you actually have to make a big transition when you move from Mumbai to Europe. Not just weather-wise, culture-wise, everything changes. The class changes, the teaching environment changes, the teaching methodology changes. So you really have to adjust on every aspect of your life. So that is something which teaches you and makes you stronger. So even though I disliked it, but that made me stronger. So that was it. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I can also relate to that. So moving on to the next question. Did you have any specific challenges during your MBA, like maybe during moving or maybe when you are searching for jobs here, or did you have anything in mind specific?
Challenges per se was not having a security that I'll be getting a job. So for me, I was always on my toes that I had to get a job as soon as it finishes. In a way, that is also good because that keeps you on your toes and always keeps you prepared. But at the same time, you will always be scared because there is no campus interview. And if you miss a chance, you will have to wait. You don't know how much you have to wait. So that is the thing that scares me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So moving on to the final two questions so that I don't make this video too long because people don't like it when it is too long. But anyway, you will find timestamps so that you can browse through different sections. I'll leave the timestamps in the description below and also in the comments so that you can click on the specific sections of the video. So what kind of support did you receive from SPJIMR in India during your transition to Netherlands? And was it smooth or did you have something particular to remember or any advice you want to give to people who have such, who apply for such kind of a global management program? What things should they keep in mind?
Okay.
So there are like two parts.
So SPJMR stays with you for life. Once you are a part of SPJMR, you are always there. Like these people will always be there whenever you need them. So everything is taken care by SPJMR itself, because when you are in India, your whatever the contact you are having with your European partner school, you don't really need to do it on yourself, and SPJMR takes care batch wise. It's easier for them and easier for us as well. The visa application process is also taken care by SPJMR also in association with Nairoda, but for us it was SPGMR who were doing everything. Even when we came here, faculties keeps on coming here. They visit us at least for faculties come here, they provide us lecture, also they come and meet us. We have a big alumni base here in Europe because this course is like running from years. So we have like people coming, graduating and settling in Europe. So we also have like a big base, alumni base, which you can always, like anytime you can contact any people, and mostly people respond if you are a SPGMR family. So this is a big advantage of being a part of SPGMR family. And to answer the second part of your question, I don't really remember what it was.
Do you want to give any advice to people who are planning to have this kind of a global, apply for a global management program in the future?
I would say that the people who are having a European dream, this is your chance to live it. If you want to like settle in Europe, have a better quality of life, want to have better work-life balance, this is the best way possible, at least I can say this, to I would say it's a SPGMR, GMP is like a gateway to your European life. That is the only thing I can say in the last.
Okay. Yeah. So, I mean, what I understand from all this is that, in short, like this kind of a program, based on what I've heard from people, is cost effective as compared to doing a normal MBA directly in Netherlands. And apart from that, you have this wealth of experience and benefits and everything, whatever he mentioned in the video. So thank you, Shashank, for giving your valuable time on a weekend.
Thank you, Samit.
I hope that you like this video. Then don't forget to smash the like button and share this video. Help each other out, because many of you I know are looking to apply for MBA and have short on finances or have certain situation. So maybe this kind of a program will give you that dimension to explore. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you have not subscribed yet. Until next video, goodbye from Netherlands. Peace.
देखो
अरे ये बढ़िया
है,
बहुत बढ़िया।